Next agenda item, we have the plans and the budget for this one.
I have a couple of extra topics here, and I want to do some comments. And I do not want to do all of these, but sometimes things come up in our session, and you have to question about what that is. So there is a definition page, a couple of pages, definitions and concepts and science for work. Also, there is a flow chart on the budget process. This is a very simple kind of flow chart.
What page are you on?
This is under finance tab. There's a couple pages of definitions, and then there is a flow chart on the budget process. And that just kind of gives you an idea of what all goes on for the budget. We've already had preliminary meetings with all of the involved departments, let them know what's needed, and make sure that they all understand how to fill out their packages, or packages are actually due back to us tomorrow. And we'll start going through all of those, and entering all that information in, and get that ready for you to start meeting with the elected officials and constitutional officers, and the budget committee, or the meeting with the departments that fall under the commissioners.
This year, we have tried to simplify this for all the offices and departments to get ready to do this electronically, setting this field in the number of numbers that they not only have to be there.
By 2 years.
Yeah, those machines need to calculate for them. We try to make it simple for them. We highlight what they need to fill in, what is in that particular line.
I even filled in all their sheets for them, all their sheets, they put in their numbers.
Go ahead.
Before we meet with all of those, we have this annual plan meeting here, where we kind of set the tone, and that is a little bit of direction as far as where we're going to move the budget. But once we meet and meet with all these different departments, that's your opportunity to ask questions. Then the budget committee gets busy and starts taking all of that, putting it together, and then we bring back to you. That work session, we can do this or not, sit on that, we'll make those changes, and then we have required advertising and public hearings, and all this has to be done before June 30th. That just kind of gives you a real quick overview of the process. As far as different things going on that can affect whether they are above or below the budget. Just real quick, I'm going to go through every bit of this because a lot of these are somewhat in line with what it should be, but things that we're watching and we're keeping an eye on. anything under taxes, that I would be a little bit of watching is your intangibles, which are, a little bit below where they were for the last couple of years. And again, that can be to time on the, for the course and the, under licenses and permits, things vary year by year, this has to be a small number, so there's really variation on where things are paid out, but this is one of those kind of special things that whatever things are collected here are also spent in stormwater, so the revenues are up here, here's the initials we get as well.
Stephanie, intangibles, is that strictly real estate?
Okay, under your governmental, now I'm not really exactly sure what is on here, what we've been watching is under your, please select it on public defender. Those have dropped significantly over the last 3 years. But on the flip side of that, information fees have gone up. So I'm not really sure what's going on with that, but that is something that we all watching. Down at the bottom of the page, that DMT Mary contract, as your, as your first plan to aware that might have come out and gone away.
We've been told that they will not be providing that for the contract that we gave them to a year ago. So we do not have the money for it, so we want to continue that service and get to the impacts from how you want to continue it versus the need for it.
Which islands are?
It's DOT money.
And I've heard that from the county, that is a statewide occurrence. They're not hitting you because of the type of county or anything. It's basically going to work.
We just entered into an agreement a little over a year ago, and for extended knowledge, because the cost that we submitted to DOT was lower than what they would pay.
Did they reimburse us from the issues and all the ways?
And then that just dropped out. It's just one of the items, as Harrison said, from the next standpoint, DOT is no longer funding. They're just saying they're not going to go low, and so they're not going to contract with over the county. But and the chairman and I discussed this yesterday. This has an impact on our community. Not only just the citizens that live in Orange County, but those that travel in and through the county on the interstate. Right, when you decide where you're going to get off the interstate, you pass an interstate, you come to an intersection that is overgrown and unkept, there's a tendency to say, I think I'll go a little bit further.
So all the mowing on us?
I'm sorry.
All the mowing.
They're going to, I think DOT indicated previously they would cut one time per year.
But the interstate's excluded.
That's right. If you want anything done on those exits and maintain those,
we do it.
We're going to have to.
Someone will have to. Yes, which falls on us. It's going to have to be taken care of if you expect those exits. Any of the state highway mowing to be done and something that we want to figure out.
See, our contract included part of that as well as some of the state routes because as I mentioned, when we presented to them our cost, they said, would you be willing to do more mileage at this price? And we said, okay. Because we used the price and that we were operating at, and they said, well, this is significantly lower than what we're paying. But even that paragraph is not sufficient for them to convene. Or they just decided blanket-wide that they're not going to be able to do it.
And so, yeah, it's my understanding, I don't think that the prisoners could get on the track if you could.
No, couldn't. No, you can't. The requirements on that, they cannot operate. They cannot operate that. There's certain restrictions on inmate use. You cannot get above a certain height, you can't work under a certain temperature, you can't up or down.
Can you go back to using swing blades?
No, sir. That would be, yeah.
I remember the swing blades.
The smaller counties like Lanier and Clinch actually were making revenue off this because they bid out the contract below the price that DOT was paying. So they're not only going to lose the revenue stream, they're also going to turn around and have
all the experience. We were actually doing it less than what the bid price was. And so again, that's the reason they came back and said, hey, are you willing to do more? And certainly, if it was going to help enhance the, you know, the state highways and our community, then the answer was certainly, yes, we'll do more. Well, no more than you get it going good, now they decide no money.
I'll have more comments.
On the mowing business, this might be off track a little bit. Would retardants come into play there as well as?
We could use those in some areas, and we can discuss that. And Robin is here and talks about maintenance a little bit more. But when you begin to spray those, you have to be careful about the surrounding area, that if that drifts over. You do have a little bit of liability there sometimes. So we have to be conscious of it.
I was thinking mainly around these exits, these interstate exits, where they are.
Well, we can get that information from public works when they have that presentation. Good question. Let me mention, if I can, one other thing, Mr. Pritchard, that we kind of, in the back of the book, you're going to find some spare sheets. You might want to pull those out. But that's your smart goal setting worksheets. If you've got information or something that you might want to go or just move along that you see in each one of these things that you may want to just make a note of, that's a good way to do it and keep it up, and we'll be able to gather those together and move along.
I shouldn't use that.
There's no problem. I thought about it before. Did that all on my own.
Purchased a machine in the sheriff's office said that it was not the model or the type that they wanted. They wanted the one that was a little bit more expensive, and we purchased that. So I'm not aware that they do not have a machine. Mr. Chairman, I think you remember this was especially bad. Related to both an ice machine as well as a fingerprint machine, the request was made that we authorize the purchase of both of those, which we did. So,
how was recently fingerprint?
necessarily some complaints, but we have received comments that the majority of those going through the probate office are referred to the police department for that process.
There are also all of our alcohol licenses are added to the city as well, therefore, they're permanent.
These teachers,
your parents, they send it, they don't send it to the sheriff's office.
I was referred to the city.
Yes.
Told the county's machine was in office.
I think that's something that we need to get a little more information on, because, again, that is a, even though small, it is a revenue stream, which kind of way, and it's also along with that, an opportunity for the citizens of Lowndes County that may be much closer to the sheriff's department and that further work with the sheriff's department, they've lost that opportunity. If there is an issue there as far as why this machine did not be working, or whether or not it's the county, SO is just not offering the service, that's what we do. So that's a good question to get asked the sheriff.
And city only fingerprints on Thursday.
I'm sorry?
City only fingerprints on Thursday, so you got to do your script.
Oh, yeah. So you can know, so I know when I got mine, and I'm just using your example, but when I got mine, I was able to do it all in one day. It took me 3 hours to do it. But I was able to do it in one day, so now if you do it on Monday, you have to wait till Thursday, get your fingerprinting, and go back.
And if you have a conflict on Thursday that week, you have to go back to probate court and do the paperwork.
My point is, that's $24,000 worth of anticipated revenue, and in 6 months, we only collected half of 1%. That's a big deal.
That is something that we can, we'll just have to discuss that with the sheriff's office, to see if there's something that we as a commissioner needs to do, or if it's something on that end that needs to be
exactly what the reason
have that conversation.
Stephanie?
On the clerk of court, the budget has dropped over the last couple of years. Any reason for that?
When we look at this historical trend on where those fees are coming, as far as what goes on, I mean, she just remits to us county. Harrison may be able to give you more of a breakdown, because he actually does have a group or so.
Let me go through that later in my presentation.
That's fine.
But I do have part of my presentation speaks to that issue.
Over fees, please again, very every year. They years ago used to do culverts at a flat fee. We were never near breaking even on those. And so we started probably about 10 years exploring what they actually cost. So we had a significant drop from that, but they just varied from year to year on what most people have to put culverts in.
I think a lot of that probably had to do with the lack of construction as well. It held the economy down, so if you're not having new homes being built and they're not putting new culverts.
Now, there are outside vendors that somebody call and have that service done and not pay them.
Right. And as we got more closer to what those private industries were charging, we saw a significant drop in the number that the county put in. The reason I'm pointing this particular line out though is last year. At this point last year we had 13,000 and we're already at 21,000 this year. So that varies from year to year. Over on page 30, this is the five employee version. We are only about 21% this year. As compared to last year, we were about 30%. Again, this sometimes this has to do with the clerk of court and how far behind she may be on submitting those. But what we
positions to the clerk's office to assist with the collection of citations. And we made an office there, and a window available just behind from the hallway, just kind of metal detector for that particular purpose. So that has helped that situation for citations. But the reference that Pearson is making is Beth has given us as much as she can, and I don't know that any additional person would actually speed that up.
But I think in all fairness here, even though it's in the clerk's reports under their line item, they're processing it as fast as they can get it and getting it out. So it's a matter of getting the material and getting the information so it can be processed. That's kind of what I'm talking about.
And it is very over time. Sometimes it has been over behind, sometimes it's, close with it. It generally runs here for a
month. And we do patch it up a year in, based on approval of county. We account for 12 months for the distributions. But that may mean you pick up as much as 100 to 200,000 more revenue a year in on approval basis, just to make sure we have comparables from year to year. During the year, you're going to get so done all over the place. But that's another problem.
And again, keep in mind that this is just a snapshot of where we're at right now in time. And, it could be that there's a little bit of a bog down and that get caught back up and then we'll show back up on it.
And that's why we do this comparison of where we were this year.
That's nice to see. Not to jump ahead, but I mean, if you look down, you're right in line with where we're at.
So. Well, one more time, I know Beth does a good job.
Again, it's just a snapshot. And then it could be the way the whole thing is, the way the information is coming in and how it's getting processed. And there's a lot of moving parts in this.
Thank you. for, in law, where it was last year, the significant change that you see in that cost was the updated website.
Chapter 12.
Yes, that was the, and you're paying for that over 4 years.
Which, if I can add to it, I know that most of you have had an opportunity to take a look at the new website that we can have. Certainly go to it, it is, it's above where we were at, it's great improvements. All the comments that I have gotten on the website, citizens have been all positive. It's easy to navigate through it, a lot of information on there. So again, if you have your opportunities, please take a look at it.
Having that few public documents on the registry would be.
There's a lot of good information on that. And again, thank Mr. Dukes and her staff for all the hard work putting it together, because they did a great job.
Abraham Hastings, Board of Elections, they are, as we are, this often ends again on what elections are in that year. They have had some election already this year, so they are good. Finances and law, actually, we're. Human resources, you'll see they're at 89%, and they have sounds really bad to be 6 months into the year, and they're 89%. They have a insurance premium that they pay the first of the year, that's about $600,000. So that's the majority of the year's insurance.
So that's all that pay and pay.
They pay that, usually as well. So that's what always makes them look like they're almost completely. Information technology, if you look at 2014 compared to 2012, they turned on, it was about one from 2013, but they have some big projects that came in at first of 2013, that were that off slightly.
Let me ask real quick, Mr. Pritchard, from your standpoint, I don't think that we're actually going to get any presentation or anything from IT, but I know the computer standpoint and the hardware of where we're at in the county, I know we've made some efforts to try to improve in those areas, or we continue in that direction as well.
Yes, sir, and for new commissioners, there was a time period where we had a 3-year rotation on all computers. That was just as we do, had in the past on the vehicle, we did the same thing to keep our fleet, a computer fleet, as a result of budget constraints, we had to do away with that. If y'all recall, last year, our inability to fund some of that computer purchase caught up to us, and we had to pay some numbers last year that we were not surprised we had to pay. Unfortunately, they just equipped to cease to function. We're trying to inch back into that rotation as monies are available. We have asked all departments, as a general process, all offices and departments, to make their request to the IT department so that then IT will assess the life expectancy on the particular computers. It's not just the department saying, I think I'd like a computer. It's, these are the computers we have. This is the age on those. What should be replaced and so forth. And we do that as well as on our cell phones and other electronic devices like that. So yes, the big expense through the IT department, of course, is as it relates to court systems and to the sheriff's departments, and keeping that information, our servers, obviously by having the capacity that we do now in the building. very good shape from the standpoint of our current capabilities, and as well as we can be with the potential for development in the future. Without knowing what those changes will be, we have positioned ourselves, I believe, as comfortably as we can at this point.
How often do we have to upgrade?
Well, it depends. You know, we've had, as technology changes, we have some particular computers that would not operate on the new software that came out, and so we had to change over as a result of that. But it really depends on the technology that comes out, and staff does a good job of trying to stay abreast of that. Our system that we use, our Eden system that handles our finances, our HR, our public works, our utilities, we develop, we purchase that program. Five. You can live almost 10 years.
And by the way, like, if you get 10 years out of it, you've done well. So we're
you get 3 years out of something.
So we would probably like to be better off, but we certainly feel that we are in a comfortable place based on our capabilities and expenditures and our service to the users.
One thing I was concerned about, Joe, and I think I touched on it last year, was just the me being a CIO, the capability, and they've done with the IT department. And you know, the contract went out. Long story short, the fiber which runs out 911 center is the city's. And I'm just hoping that one day we possibly get to a point that we're, you know, self sufficient on what have you.
And we are discussing, and will tomorrow at some point, discussions we've had about broadband and availability in our area and so forth. And we have budgeted some fiber connections. We have utilized some point-to-point connections for fire departments, et cetera. So, we, as a county, because of the distance, have a little more complexity in dealing with some of those issues of connectivity as opposed to a municipality who has a shorter distance between their offices and so forth. But it is a concern, and it's something that we keep pretty close to the forefront when we sit down with that department.
Because, I mean, if I wasn't there, I wouldn't know, but I know firsthand that they don't have really capability to prepare for what they used to have in regards to if something's happening even right now. To be honest with you, along Madison Highway, that route, if I were things down to 911 Center, just something to think about.
So, Commissioner Rockenmaker's talking about, you know, what we need and where we are. One of the big expenses that we have is storage. I think there's an idea out there that if you save it to your computer, it goes somewhere, and it's just living there for free. You all will see with some of the purchases that are made and the maintenance contracts that you were there annually, that there's a tremendous amount of cost involved in storing all of that. So what we have begun to look at where we can are going to web-based storage options. If there is a company that we're doing business with, a vendor that we have, has that web-based storage option, we can do that without having to actually plant that data in one of our service centers here in Lawrence County, then we're taking advantage of that to keep them in the storage they can. We had a huge sand upgrade that was a couple of $100,000 over several years, and that's just because of the retention that we're under. So we're trying to farm those things out where we have that capability.
Also, just real quick, and then we need to move on, but from an IT standpoint, as all of you know, one issue that we may have to look at it down the road shortly certainly is security in the system that we do have. That may have to be something that's going to have to be addressed certainly IT department is staying on top of those issues right now. But as you know, there is a lot of personal information that's in there. Hacking is an issue that we all have to be concerned about and dealing with. It doesn't matter where, when, and what you're dealing with. But the county is trying to do everything that we can to minimize that. I don't know that you could say you can actually insulate yourself from it and prevent it, but I think that we have an obligation to look at it to see if we're doing everything that we can do to prevent it. So those are some things that we'll be that you'll be hearing about as we kind of move along with that. That's great.
All right, payroll on page 7. General facilities, we have an idea of this. This is a department that we use to account for things like countywide postage and countywide cell phones, generic things like that, that are not attributable to a specific department. On that same page, you have the tax commissioner, the board of assessors, and all of the facilities maintenance for those departments that are in the general fund. And you'll see that those are all pretty much in line. Right on page 8, county engineer and soil water. You recall about the soil water fees earlier. This is where those are all set. And those the primary cost there is in worksheets for the school and some educational programs on soil water. Under contingency, it looks like we are much better shape than we were last year. That's because your contingency budget increased significantly from last year. We did work towards increasing our contingency, but we had some special items that we added to the budget late. And there were some agreements that were in process, and so instead of putting those in specific budget lines, we put those in contingency. So that looks much higher than it actually is.
What the statement referred to is things you may call part of the P4 initiative that we entails understanding assuming responsibility for their sewer treatment. We put monies in contingency in the event that that process was approved by the Department of Defense. That is in the approval stage, and we anticipate that it will go into actual operation perhaps by October. We will not sure when it might be, so we put those numbers in for that. And it would be necessary that we continue that consideration in the budget.
Yeah, real quick on that particular item, that particular effort through the P4 initiative and the county's work with the folks out in the Air Force Base. That one item right there is catching a lot of attention nationally in DOT through that whole process about how that came about, the money that it's actually going to save Moody, and at the same time, the P4 initiative, it's not 100% up to it. It was an initiative that was put together by the Department of Defense to see how local communities could work with their local military installation to find win-win situations for where we're doing. How can we cooperate together and be good for both? This particular situation came up. It is a win-win for the county, because the county at the same time will be able to gain some additional capacity, some redundancy if we need it, up in that northeast section of around the Moody area, the Venus area up there for water and sewer issues if we need it. But at the same time, they're able to get the savings that they'll be able to get from us taking over the water and sewer system. It has caught a lot of attention, and there's going to be folks from here were asked to go to Monterey, California, where they're having a meeting on a lot of these and make a presentation about that relationship between Lowndes County and Moody Air Force Base and how it all came about.
In addition to those, there's also members there earmarked for the prominent, because that was paid at that point, it was left for discussion and agreement, which is already been, as you know, the agreement has been sealed behind.
Under Superior Court, the biggest fluctuation in that area since we were ordered and how much activity they have. Over on page 9, you can see your ankle monitoring, the court reports, the district attorney, and the district court administrator. That is a there's five.
let me ask, there was some discussion about beginning to study the difference between purchase and lease on some of this equipment. So that comes later.
Well, Harrison will not be doing that later. It will be that during the budget, we will bring that up.
Okay.
It does make the hero Harrison's neck stand up when I start talking about the lease purchase.
No, I'm fine with the lease purchase option, actually. There was a mechanism used in a prior one that was very convoluted, and I think the cost of it was more. I do believe, especially with road equipment, these capital leases where you can talk about them, that is where most counties are going. The operation, the repair costs, when you get into that fourth or fifth year of operating, is tremendous. And these companies are more than willing to take that back, give you credit, and do it in the lease, and they're off the road with you. So I just think they're good to.
Yeah, I can see that. There again, that's part of the study, is looking at which one are you going to best benefit from, because you will, by having new equipment consistently on the road, you're going to reduce maintenance, the fleet management portion of that's going to come down expeditiously. So I just wanted to take a look at that and see which way we need to make a shift.
I totally agree with that.
Services. I know at one point there was the new agent that was hired and then unhired. He took another job somewhere else. Has that position been filled at this time? I haven't seen anything on that. What has it been? Okay.
Thank you. this helps offset what is in your general fund expenditures for jail. But what we have encountered over the years is things that have been traditionally paid for out of the jail operations fund. That fund's no longer sufficient to cover all of those. So we did try to push some of those back out of the general fund a couple years ago, but we ended up just having to move it back to fund.
Thank you.
I'm just asking, but is the charge for 911 services on a cell phone the same as it is on a landline?
But you, if you're a resident of Gwinnett County, you purchase your phone and you come down here and not pay, we're not getting Gwinnett back.
Gotcha. So you really end up specifically with a net loss. I know a lot of folks are just, they're foregoing the landlines, which reflects here, and using their cell phones all the way through. But there again, if you're purchased for your cell phone and your payment point is somewhere other than Lyons County, then that fee does not come here. So you end up with a net loss ultimately for a community like ours that has somewhat of a mobile community in some aspects.
I was just thinking like a base, the military people that's from other places.
Military or VSU?
Oh, VSU, yeah.
VSU, oh, and you.
Well, expenditure wise, they're pretty much in line with where they were last year.
I think later on, we've got, when you look at our broadband, we have 10 providers of broadband service, but from the cable television standpoint, we only have two. We have MediaCom, and we have a company in this area called Altice.
Did we rectify the situation?
We don't have a franchise agreement, and their franchise agreement was with us. A couple of years ago, when the FCC changed their laws, they no longer require local utility providers related to internet and TV and stuff to have franchise agreements with local governments. They can decide to have that agreement directly with the state. So from what we can tell right now, and I think that what the attorneys have researched is that Altice is registered with the state, but they do not have a franchise agreement with Lawrence.
They were at one time called Coverage, and they changed their name. They've been purchased by a number of very good companies, but at one time part of Falcon, and they went to Charter and so forth. But I've spoken with someone at the Public Service Commission, that was the agency that was supposed to be able to relate to. And part of this came about because once companies such as AT&T decided they wanted to get into the cable provided service, they all agreed that they wanted to go to the Public Service Commission to get their agreements as opposed to going to 300 plus cities and 159 counties. They deal with the county commissions and city councils of all of those. But it appears that there has been a disconnect between the public service keeping them on the straight and narrow as it applies to making those contributions. And you've seen that as paper reference to the blood part and the controversy about the TV. We've been following that same thing. The chairman is aware that the area around Newton, where it does not have adequate cable or broadband service as a result of this company's, I guess, changing from a cable provider to a supplier of direct TV.
I remember passing the complaints to you
Like
a year or so ago.
Oh, we had that on a regular basis.
About it, that's what I was wondering.
So yeah, it normally comes about April when the rains start playing. Huh? That's when you start getting complaints. Because the folks up there that's on that particular service, they have been picking up to get the rain fall.
They've been dropping channels and telling people that if they move from, they sell the house or if they move from a different house, they no longer will provide services. So it's a significant problem.
So franchise doesn't apply to them. It's the state that actually enforces.
Yeah, they can make a choice in the state. They can either go to the locals or they can go to the Public Service Commission. When I spoke to the Public Service Commission, they said, well, they're really your problem. I said, no, we understand that they're your problem. They said, well, they're your problem. So.
And meanwhile, the citizens see something on their bill that says Lowndes County franchise fee, so they're calling hoping that the county can help them. Because they're getting the same
runaround
that the county
is going to be called. And the chairman has made members of the delegation aware of this, that this is a problem.
There's no income from the dish or the direct or anything.
Under licenses and permits, under alcohol,
Chairman and I discussed a problem that's right now here on East Lake, that particular area falls outside of
member for the ISO rate. They have to do the 70 miles of fire station. And in it, like, here, falls outside of that. So we approached, our fire department approached, our fire department discussing the potential for an automatic aid, which would mean that in the event of a fire in that area, both fire departments, both Lake Park as well as our closest Twin Lakes would be called and notified and respond. That difference makes them eligible for a federal fire rating. That document would be drawn up and presented to the county of Lake Park to define themselves.
They acted.
Yeah, they went ahead and acted as a sign of good faith that what they will do is prepare for a number of residents of Eagle Lake there and need to express their appreciation. So that is in the works.
Quick question. I see the line saying investment income. What could be classified as investment income if we were to look at any options?
That's typically anything that we make off of our regular bank accounts. And at the time that we were able to do it, in the investment that we made in trade or something like that. We've not done that in 10 years. This would be certainly income off of our bank accounts.
I guess we're the ones from that, huh?
Yeah. As you can see, it's not a huge money maker right now. At one point in time, we can probably put a roof back.
Yeah.
It was
probably less than that.
Really?
Yeah, you were, well, before the recession.
Yeah.
And you were had money in what we call LGIP accounts, governmental accounts.
Let's move on if we can. We're running a little bit behind.
Planning, this is Jason and his staff, But other than that, pretty much in line with where you would be. Over on page 30, this is a draft that we've been working for several years now. Basically breaks the general fund out by how you spend it. The board commissioners and administration get about 8 cents of every dollar. Elections, 1 cent. Tax commissioner, 3 cents. Board assessors, 3 cents. Engineering, 1 cent. Court services are 11%. Sheriff is 35 cents. And then you see animal control, ambulance services, your other emergency services, and then the chief authority, and your outside agencies. We had this question come up last year, how that historically has trended out, and so we tried to put that in a graph for you. The section that you see in blue is the things that fall under the board commissioners. So on that first graph, it's the board commissioners and administration, engineering, animal control, and some of the things that fall under other emergency services.
Always.